fall of 07, a group of boys, coaches, parents, teachers, students, and a town came together to experience and achieve something very special. Now, it didn't come easy. It took a lot of hard work, but there was always a sense they would finish the job. Now, a lot of these boys will move on at the end of the year to college and their future, but they'll always look back with a smile on their face when they think about the memories, friendships, and of course, that championship season.
I'd like to welcome you all to the annual Moorestown High School football banquet. I'd first like to thank everyone who played a part and contributed to the season that was special for so many people. There were numerous achievements this year, starting with an undefeated season, a state championship, coach of the year, player of the year, and many individual season and postseason honors. In addition to the highlights and achievements, this team faced a great deal of adversity. A big-time two-way starter, Dom Sebastiani, suffered an ankle injury in the preseason and was forced to sit out for several weeks. The game Dom returned into the lineup, our quarterback and captain, John Eller, seriously injured his kidney and did not return to the field this season. The absence of these two talents ultimately provided motivation within the team to eliminate complacency, to play our hardest, and to cherish every moment out on that football field. With the goal in mind and the team that made it happen, we finished the job. So with the highest congratulations to the team that literally made history in 2007, let us now look back on that championship season.
with our game of the week, and it's Triton at Moorestown.
I don't want to be losing to Triton every single year. It's not going to happen. It stops now.
All in, ready to go. Triton at Moorestown. Moorestown's John Eller to Brian Burnham. What a catch! You can't stop that, Burnham. You just try to contain him. Then on defense, Mickey Reynolds with the interception, and he takes it all the way in for the score. Moorestown a winner, 44-0.
Hey, congratulations to the Moorestown football team. We only serve champions here, so anytime you guys get hungry, just come right over. Thank you, congratulations again.
The favorite game for me would probably have to be Middleton South, because last year when they beat us in the state championship, just left a horrible feeling in everyone's stomach. And that kind of pushed everyone over the winter, over the summer, to work harder. And then we got to play them again next year in the playoffs. Just felt so good to beat them good too.
That state championship this year against Long Branch, I saw it was a good way to finish a career, come together, finish out the undefeated season. I mean, we started off the game real nice, kickoff return by Mikey for a touchdown, really pumped us up. Then I come in and throw an interception, that wasn't too good at the time. We kind of finished out the half not too well in that cold weather. Came out second half, just started the game. I asked coach if we could go long to Brian. He let me do it. We started off the half with a touchdown pass, and then we just carried it on for the rest of the game, came off the win.
Last year and this year is probably both Middletown South, because last year they beat us and it motivated us through this year. And this year when we got to play them, like Sergeant said, it just felt so good to beat them.
The most exciting play was Timber Creek had the ball, and they kept pounding running the ball because, like I said, it was bad conditions out, and D-Hood kept stuffing this kid, and he kept giving the ball, and D-Hood looks at me, and he's like, Mikey, why does this boy think he can still run me over? I'll never forget that for the rest of my life. I've made a lot of plays, I've seen a lot of plays, but the look in D-Hood's eye, and like, he must have had like 50 tackles that game, because they kept running the same play over and over.
I'd have to say, one of my proudest moments was receiving a touchdown pass from John Eller, first game of the season, here on this field. That cornerback there, it wasn't a very big play, but it was right before the half, and scoring my only touchdown of my career was pretty exciting, and I just want to thank John for that and for Coach for the opportunity.
Baseball! 1, 2, 3!
Baseball!
55. 11.
Thank you.
Catholic High School Eagles.
There's a certain genius to certain people that get things done and make it appear easy.
So you're here, five-step drops.
Bill was aware of the fact that they had this, quote, genius label tacked on him. He used to make fun of it. Two glasses of wine and Bill made fun of a lot of things, including himself. You know, I'd tease him about it a little bit. And he said, you know, I'm about as much a genius as you are, Emil. You know, which pretty much defined it.
I just knew that I had to go to Grambling. I didn't call anybody. I didn't make any appointments. I didn't want to go through all that bullshit. You know, I wanted to feel it myself, you know, because of what I felt for him and what he had accomplished, and I did that. And I walked around. I walked over to the stadium and looked around and said, man, this is it. This is the place.
I think one of the great things about Bill Walsh is he could take a person that didn't see the depth of his talents, bring it out, and then make him better, not only as players, but as people, as family, as parents, and help them establish what they are today. And he did that for a lot of players, and I'm sure he did that for a lot of coaches, and he really helped me that way.
Game ball! Coach Bill Walsh.
I just wonder, how many days did he go home and cry? How many days would he go over and wonder how you can get equipment for Grambling? How many people did he have to go to with his hat in his hand to make sure that they had a proper facility to play in? That's the story of Eddie Robinson.
You write your name here. You write your name here.
It always amazes me when people tell me I pull myself up by my own bootstraps. You know, Eddie pulled me up. What he went through, what he had to do, how he coached. You know, I had what I called an African-American style of coaching, Eddie Robinson. That's what I had.
Well,
out really wide. It'll take the outside backer with it. All right, Joel!
That was getting back to the state championship game and playing Long Branch in the finals. And, on the opening play of that game, watching Mikey Reynolds take the ball, 90 yards for a touchdown. We just never looked back after that point. And it was a real great way to end our season. It was an undefeated season. I know I'll remember it for the rest of my life. And I know my teammates will as well.
It's a great season. No memory is ever going to compare to walking off Rutgers Field, champions with all my friends, all my teammates. But, right up there with that is going to be, for the last 4 years, my goal has been to be a starter on Moorestown High School varsity football team, and I got that chance in game two of this season against Cheryl West. And that game might not stick out in a lot of people's minds, but walking off that field knowing I started that game, played my heart out, is always going to be right up there with winning the state championship for me.
Usually every day I walk into the locker room and turn around and see Adam Kostick with fists in motion and an antagonizing face at the other end of the swing. I just hope Adam will realize that violence is not the answer.
On D-Days, we would kind of just hang out and, take a knee. And we were always kind of just hanging out. And I would always throw to him, of course. And then...
I got the hands.
And then, on practice, Horton staring at us, walks over and starts singing. It's like, secret lovers. we go.
And from then on, every time.
Amen, every
together,
time.
He would just be like...
Secret lovers. I can't deny anything.
Peace.
The most was in the championship game when Shane came in the huddle and he said, double wing, double tight, victory formation. It just kind of sealed, everything we've been working for this entire season.
Yeah.
One thing I remember this season is our game against Wall when I wasn't playing. And, I guess during halftime, all the cheerleaders came up to the car that I was sitting in. That was cool. And then after the game, all the players came up and, said hi and everything. That was cool.
The Hamilton West playoff game, we were doing kick return. And coach wanted a JV kickoff to assemble. And, the week before, we watched film and we saw their main man, the man in the middle, he calls everyone down. Well, what he liked to do when he got fired up, everyone was getting fired up, he liked to scream at the top of his lungs and go, ah! So we thought it'd be, or coach thought it would be funny if Kenny would do it, but he really wouldn't. But when Leffridge was about to kick the ball, he's like, everyone down, ah! It was pretty funny. Everyone started laughing. Coach was like, do it again. I want to see that again. And again, he goes, starts the kickoff, goes, ah. But he didn't do anything like the kid from Hamilton West did, but it was pretty good, man. I like that.
Well, it was getting up early in the morning for doubles and going in and seeing what new invention Mr. Bratton had made for us. It was always like an assortment of just random wood and rope and PVC pipe, and he just wants to see what he can build. But I guess he had fun with it, and we used it, so thank you.
Probably Dever and all those little comments, like communism and some other things, and just going to miss that a lot about the line and everything.
The scrimmage against Lawrenceville Prep went up to my man, John E. I never scored a touchdown catching the ball over the shoulder, so it's my only request. First pass play of the game, toss up a ball like Peyton Manning, called over the shoulder, dived into the end zone like Reggie Bush.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, my toughest practice experience was definitely the...
I kind of suspected something like that was coming.
A few seconds ago when Dom over here pied Garrick in the face, Garrick was trying to go on with his little interview thing. It's pretty funny.
It was the lateral crab tackle drills. It's when we had to get on all fours and crab back and forth in front of the bag and then run out and tackle it. Then we was going to do it over and over and over again. Coach Devin would make us do it just over and over. So it was crazy. But, you know, he always said that you have to go when you're tired. And I think this drill really helped us to get that mindset in the game, especially when you're playing both ways.
It was just winning a state championship game, just looking around, seeing everybody so happy, knowing that we actually did it, and like everything that we worked for, we finally got it done and won it.
What can you say about Coach Horton? Well, I guess if you're not part of the team, you just have to realize that there's more to the man than his trademark sunglasses and the traditional beanie. From a sideline point of view, you may see a poised leader, strategically sending troops in and out with plans that result in one thing and one thing only, and that's victory. However, there's a passion that burns deep inside this man, the likes of which the world has never seen. But I now realize what exactly Coach is working on. Bring it in here, boys. Well, Coach, I'll get on my shoulders. We love you. Congratulations.
Love you, Coach.
Don't let nobody wear this number next year.
All you coaches.
You created a masterpiece.
Jerry.
Look.
I could go after every play, not just a couple of laser 80 down.
Thank you.
baby. There ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby.
Don't you know that I set you free? Thought that you would always stand for me, girl. Let that young, I made a vow. Some way, somehow.
Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough.
Hey, you only got two left. You seniors, you play football since you were little. You got two games left. Let's get the win. Right. Yes, we want to stay championship. That's the biggest prize. But if you can go undefeated, yes. Like I said, this week, you will remember that for the rest of your life. For the rest of your life.
Mays, right half counter two.
Three! Three! Three. Right there!
Don't get
hooked! Strong side.
I start!
13!
Yeah!
Go!
Razor, go back 30.
Look at that!
4-5, sir.
Laser, 37 tight end cover lead. No mo, 88 right half down.
I want five! Go! I want five!
Turn it up, Brian!
Go, 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 go.
Moorestown won the state championship and completed their undefeated season, the first time in 50 years, and invited back the 57 team to celebrate together. Congratulations to you all, and as Coach said, you'll remember this the rest of your life.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
All right, my favorite game was Long Branch. Shit. My bad. I got you. I'm fine with that. Right now?
Smile. Smile.
Hey, I'm John
Elder. I'm John. I'm fine with that. Right now?
Smile.
The play I always...
Start again.
Ah, oh, God.
Chill out. Just chill out.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
I want you to smile.
All right.
Smile. Let's see your team.
It's okay, yeah?
There you go. Stop talking.
All right. I'm fine with that. Right now? Am I good?
Shh, I'm talking. Yeah, you good? You can say hello to everybody.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
funny memories during stretching, and oh, you guys are fags.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
Reroll, retake.
Yeah, you just keep yelling.
Yes. Check.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
What I miss the most about Moorestown football, class of 2007. Sorry, we're class of 2008. You can keep that on there, though.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
What do you think?
That's great. What can you say about Coach Horton? Well, I guess if you're not part of the team, you have to realize that there's more.
I'm sorry.
All right. Wait, I gotta take out the hair thing.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
All right. Hey, hold on a sec. Out of the background there.
All right. The thing I want to miss the most.
Oh, hold on.
All right, guys, zip it.
Okay, smile.
The thing I'm probably going to miss the most is Devin and all his little comments, like communism and a couple other things that he said to our line.
Hold on a second.
I'm fine with that. Right now?
They were just some of the funniest things I ever heard. Stuff like communism and...
I'm fine with that. Right now?
Ready?
Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no river low.